Nothing just came out with the Ear 2s, so let's take a look and see how they compare against the AirPods Pro 2s and Samsung's Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, two of the very best earbuds on the market right now. We have 13 different things to compare, from their designs to comfort to sound quality, all the way down to their value. Starting off with the design, the AirPods and the Nothing Ear 2s, they feature a stem design, whereas the Galaxy Buds 2 Pros, they are stemless. Personally, I do prefer having a stem as it makes it so much easier to put them in your ear and also to take them out without you messing up your audio controls. I do have to give the design to Nothing. The earbud itself does look almost identical to Apple's design, but Nothing, of course, has this see-through design in their stem, which is not only a one-of-a-kind design, but also something that looks absolutely stunning. One thing that I do really like about the Buds 2 Pro is that they've got this matte finish as opposed to the glossy finish of the other two, and they also come in three colors, black, purple, and white, with the matte black ones looking especially nice. The AirPods and the Nothing Ear 2s, they only come in white, although the Ear 2s will likely come in black as well, at a later point, just like they did with the Ear 1s. Now, when it comes to the cases, the AirPods case is the smallest and also the most compact out of the three, taking up the least amount of volume. Samsung's case is thicker than the other two, but also the most durable, with a full matte finish that resists fingerprints and scratches better. With Nothing, we have this unique see-through design, which is really, really stunning. However, it is also the least durable one when it comes to scratches, as you can probably see with the Ear 1s. Now, in terms of case-specific features, Samsung's case stands out for its unique and convenient dual LED light indicator for the battery life, making it really easy to see how much battery you have left in your case and your earbuds, as opposed to just the one LED light that we have on the Nothing Ear 2s and the AirPods, which can only show you the battery life of either the earbuds or the case, depending on if the earbuds are inside the case or not. Samsung's case also integrates with Samsung's SmartThings Fi network, allowing you to locate the earbuds and the case on the map as long as someone with a Samsung phone walks by. Apple's case also has some unique features, including a built-in speaker for alerts and a U1 chip for quickly locating it within Apple's Find My network. However, its glossy finish is also prone to scratches. Now, comfort is very subjective, but to me at least, the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, they just feel too heavy. Even after me twisting them to make them even more secure in my ears, I still feel like they're not secure enough. Both the Nothing Ear 2s and the second gen AirPods Pros are very secure as the stem's weight is pushing them down. In fact, I have actually found the Nothing Ear 2s to be slightly more comfortable than the AirPods as they were considerably lighter. The comfort level will purely depend on your ear's shape though. They do all come with multiple ear tips, with Apple offering you 4 to pick from, and Samsung and Nothing offering you 3. However, they all have a great ear tip fit test, which automatically detects the right ear tip for you. And they all offer some sort of water slash sweat resistance. The Nothing Ear 2s offer an IP54 rating and IP55 for the case, meaning that they should be fine in dealing with sweat and light rain. The AirPods Pro 2s have a weaker rating of IPX4, same for the case. Although I have actually showered with my AirPods Pro 1s just to test this, and I've also used them in proper rain, and they were just fine. And the Buds 2 Pro feature IPX7, which means that it can be fully submerged in up to 1 meter of water up to 30 minutes, and they should be just fine. All in all, they'll all be fine in rain, it's just that Samsung offers you that extra peace of mind with the higher water rating. When it comes to controls, the Nothing Ear 2s and the second gen AirPods Pros are identical. You hold a stem to enable transparency slash noise cancelling modes, and then the usual double tap to skip to the next song and triple tap to skip to the previous song. And all of these controls can be customized for each earbud. However, for some reason, Nothing decided to add these weird sound effects when you put them in your ear. You get this sort of like interference sound, and when you enable noise cancelling, you get like a bass kick. And when you turn on transparency, you can literally hear a person breathing. I think this is just way too much, and as of right now, there's no way to disable this. Apple doesn't do any of these weird sound effects, and I've also found that interacting with them was way more responsive and instant. I was also not entirely sure where to tap on the Nothing Ear 2s, as in which side of the stem. The AirPods do have this indent here, which does make it way easier. Samsung basically has the exact same controls, it's just that rather than pressing on the stem, you simply touch on the earbud itself, which I personally don't like, as it does occasionally mess up with my fit. So yeah, stem controls are definitely superior. And now let's talk about the big one, the sound quality. So I'm no audiophile by any means, I'm more of a casual listener, and to my ears, the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro definitely sounded the best. They had the richest soundstage with a good amount of bass and very clear vocals, vocals which were especially noticeable when I was listening to podcasts. These sounded very, very impressive, to the point where they reminded me, in some ways, of my AirPods Max. So yeah, I was very surprised of how good the Buds 2 Pro really were. Also, the Buds 2 Pro support 24-bit audio if you are on a Samsung phone. So if you use apps such as Tidal or Apple Music and you select 24-bit lossless, you'll really be able to hear the difference. The AirPods Pro 2s also sound good, but their soundstage just isn't as rich as the Buds 2 Pros. So you'll notice that some of the instruments kind of merge together, and whilst listening to podcasts, the voices just don't feel as punchy as they do with the Buds 2 Pro. Their bass is also not quite as defined as the Buds 2 Pro, so if you do prefer a flatter sound that still sounds great, then the AirPods Pro 2s are a great option. When it comes to the Nothing Ear 2s, initially the sound was meh, nothing special. But then they got a software update which also enabled their own 24-bit LDHC standard, which by the way works on any modern Android phone, and this made a huge difference. To the point where they sounded almost as good as the AirPods Pros 2. Not quite there yet, but very close, with just slightly less bass and slightly less clarity in the instruments and vocals. But the difference to my ears at least was shockingly small after the update. And you can actually tweak the audio of the Ear 2s and the Buds 2 Pros to sound even better thanks to their dedicated app, which allows you to tweak the equalizer settings, change the controls, update the AirPods, and a lot more stuff, including a 360-degree audio option on the Buds 2 Pro, which works in a very similar way to Apple's spatial audio, where it gives you the impression that you're in the middle of the instruments, especially with head tracking activated. With the AirPods, everything is done through the Bluetooth settings. There is no specific app, and to adjust the equalizer settings, you literally have to go into the iPhone settings, music, and then change the EQ from there, which just isn't as convenient.
Okay, and now we're doing a microphone test starting off with the AirPods Pro 2s, so let us know what you think of the sound quality.
Right, and this is a test of the microphone on the Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, so let us know what you think of this sound quality.
And lastly, this is a microphone test on the Nothing Ear 2s, so let us know which one you think sounds the best.
Noise cancelling wise, the AirPods Pro 2s have the best noise cancelling here, by being able to remove somewhere around 90% of the traffic noise outdoors. The Buds 2 Pros can remove maybe about 70% or so, so definitely not as good. While the Nothing Ear 2s can actually remove maybe about 80 to 85%, so very close to the AirPods Pro 2s, it's just that they have this constant white noise that I found to be very distracting. Now, you can actually tweak the amount of noise cancelling through the app. It's currently set to high, but you can tweak it to adaptive or low. So that is doable, and in that case, the amount of white noise will be reduced, of course, at the expense of more noise going through. They also all feature a transparency mode. The AirPods Pros are definitely the best here. Like, they're so good that it's like you're not even wearing earbuds at all. Like, people around you sound natural, and so does your own voice. Samsung's transparency is also really good for people around you, just not as good for your own voice, which does get noticeably distorted. A cool thing about Samsung's transparency mode is that you can actually set it to automatically activate whenever it detects that you are talking. And Nothing transparency is straight up bad. Like, the voices are extremely muffled, you can still make out what, you know, they're saying, but it's a major downgrade in quality compared to the other two. Battery life-wise, with active noise cancelling enabled, the Nothing Ear 2s are rated at 22.5 hours for the case and 4 hours for the earbuds, with a total of 26.5. The Galaxy Buds 2 Pro are rated at 18 hours for the case, but 5 hours for the buds, for a total of 23 hours, while the AirPods 2 Pro are rated for 24 hours for the case and 6 hours for the buds, for a total of 30 hours. So the AirPods definitely do have the longest battery life here. However, the AirPods can only charge via Lightning as opposed to USB Type-C on the other two, which is a major downside. They all feature wireless charging as well, but only the AirPods and the Samsung Buds 2 Pro can charge at 5 watts wirelessly, whereas the Nothing Ear 2s can only charge at 2.5 watts wirelessly. Now, the AirPods do actually support MagSafe, which can be useful if you have one of these 3-in-1 stands or even a MagSafe car charger, as the AirPods would automatically snap into place and charge. And of course, if you have a phone that supports reverse wireless charging, which the iPhone doesn't, you can also charge these from the back of that phone. Just take a look at how sleek the Nothing Phone 1 looks, charging the Ear 2s, and same goes for the S23 in matte black. And they all support fast cable charging, with a few minutes of charging being able to provide you with multiple hours of listening time. Having said all of this, which one brings you the most value? Well, the AirPods Pro 2s are definitely the most expensive ones at $250 or £250. And although they do offer you the best noise cancelling, transparency, and controls, I think that's a very steep price. On top of this, if you want to use these with an Android phone, a lot of the things won't work, such as Siri, and I've also found that the maximum volume was significantly lower than it is on iOS. So yeah, I wouldn't really recommend these with non-Apple products. The Galaxy Buds 2 Pro are a bit more affordable at $230 or £220, and with this you do get the best sound quality, the best water resistance, and still a great noise cancelling and transparency modes, while also being able to use them with any device, Android, Windows, and even iOS. Yes, that 24-bit audio is indeed limited to Samsung phones only, and you cannot use the app on iOS either, but other than that, these are fully usable, with no volume limitations or anything like that. And if you are part of Samsung's ecosystem, just like with the AirPods, you'll be able to seamlessly switch between multiple devices at the same time. And lastly, we have the Nothing Ear 2s, which only cost $149 or £130 in the UK. That is less than half the cost of the AirPods, and £100 less than the Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 Pro. Sure, the transparency mode is noticeably worse, but the noise cancelling is still decent, and the sound quality is surprisingly good with LHDC enabled, which combined with that super unique design, I would say that these are absolutely worth it. Not only that, but their app works on both Android and iOS, and they too support multi-device connection of up to 2 devices at the same time. You can check all of these out by using the links below. And yeah, I hope you've all enjoyed this video. I'm Daniel, this means ZONEofTECH, and I'll see you guys in the next one. ZONEofTECH, signing out. Cheers.